Hi, hello. Today I like to share some of my thoughts on the increasing importance of focus, the need for focus on human beings. In my last session at the NATCOM, NIPM annual conference, I was asked at the end of the valedictory session to share some of my thoughts. And I suggested to all HR professionals, this is the best of the time for HR professionals to be in. I said that there is no business without people. And often when it is asked a question, business first or people first, somebody said in one of the sessions that it is a chicken and egg problem. I said, no, it's not a chicken and egg problem. It's very clearly people first, because it is people who make business or destroy business. So therefore, I think we need to understand people, focus on people, and help them to be enablers, help them to discover their potential and apply it. I've also said that is the reason why we are talking about human possibilities management rather than merely a human resource management. I have also said human resources are unlimited capabilities, but we don't often discover these capabilities. I have also suggested that the most important quality that HR managers should cultivate is being human. If you are not human, if you don't love your neighbor, if you don't love the people in your family, in your organization, in the society around, and if you can't look at people as people, you cannot be a good HR manager. So the main message I have given to HR fraternity is that it is high time that we focus on the human part of human resource management or human resource development. What is focusing on human? I think it begins with understanding of oneself. I think it's very important for people to have insights into themselves, because somewhere down the line we may have neglected focusing on ourselves. What are we capable of achieving? In the Maslow's need hierarchy, several decades ago, Maslow said, you reach self-actualization when you start asking yourself question, what am I meant to be? What is it that I am capable of achieving? So I actualize myself. I have several times heard people like even Sadhguru saying that we don't even use 1% of our competencies. We don't even use 1% of what we are capable of doing. Now this is something which we have been saying for several years when we talked of Johari window as a concept, where we said there is a part of our talent which is known to us and known to others, and another part which is known to us only, and there is a third part which is observed by others, and a fourth part which neither you know nor others know. And I always maintain this fourth part, which is unexplored competencies that we have, will be as much as 95%. We never measured it. It is simple logic. In fact, I think one would say that 95% unexplored talent may be an understatement. It may be even 99%. Simply, symbolically to indicate that in our lifetime, we don't use even a small part of our capabilities. Otherwise, you see a child born in the last few months or for a couple of years, how facilitating that child is in handling various gadgets, which I think about 30 to 40 years ago, we may have taken several months and several years even acquired. So today, the young mind, I think the moment you give him a gadget, he fiddles with it, and he can very easily scroll, whether it is a Facebook or a Twitter or diagrams or films and things of that kind. Within about maybe a couple of years, the child is able to master it, which shows that there is a hidden talent, and all that you need is circumstances. And these circumstances that today's child has, 30 years ago we didn't have. So what does it show? it shows that there is phenomenal amount of talent which can be brought out from within us, which is available, and it is the circumstances which make the difference. Today we have some of these circumstances. Maybe 30 to 40 years ago, the circumstances may be a lot more to bring out the best in us. It also would mean bring out the worst in us. Therefore, it's very important for HR professionals to focus on the positive side of human beings. Learn to create love at workplace, happiness at workplace, and make sure people get certain amount of freedom to be able to make a difference in their own life and in the lives of others. That is where octopus values become very important enablers of human resource development. Openness, where an organization creates an atmosphere where people feel free to express their views, opinions, free to undertake certain kinds of activities within certain kind of a context and so on. Collaboration, where people understand, respect each other, and try to help each other, work as a team, and do not develop egoism to say that I can accomplish this alone. Nothing can be accomplished all by oneself. Trust and trustworthiness, so that we make the workplace a happy place where people are trusted, respected, and so on. Autonomy, certain amount of freedom for people to do whatever they want to do. Ability to proact, take initiative. Authenticity, to be able to speak what you feel without fear that somebody is going to reprimand you. And when issues come up, confront and explore, experiment. So octopus values are values that are very much a HR kind of values. That is why in my book, HRD Missionary, I have talked of a HR prayer to seek the Almighty's blessings to lead us to a place where there is enough of freedom to express one's own self, discover oneself, and make a difference in the lives of others. So in conclusion, I would like to say, today is the best of times for HR professionals. You are lucky if you are designated as a HR professional. And don't get upset if you are not an HR professional. Maybe that's good for you. You don't have to have a professional qualifications to be a HR professional, because I would like to maintain that everyone who is human, who is constantly discovering one's own talent and using it for making a difference in the lives of others, is a HR professional. So this is a broad definition, and therefore HR profession has to move in the direction of constant discovery, restlessness, and creation of constant happiness for self and others. So all the best from TVRLS.